This is the story of a lovely little girl that had lost something very precious of her own. It was just another ordinary day when suddenly things began to change.
Daddy, I don't like the dark.
It's okay, Bella. I'll fix in a minute. See? I told you.
Mom was pretty.
Yes, she was.
Could I keep this?
Sure. But let's go. It's cold in here.
I know more spells than you. Not even a chance. Prove it then. See, I told you, half of those spells are not even real. You're a cheating fairy. Nobody gives me credit that I deserve.
Bella, are you ready for a bedtime story?
I'm always ready for my bedtime story.
Yes, I think it was a silly question. But the question is, what book?
Magicka.
Again? I read this story yesterday. And the day before.
That's my favorite book.
Okay. There once was a magical land, far, far away, full of fairies and other magical creatures. Most fairies used their magic only for good. They made their life easier.
And as the Queen Fairy looked out for the forest, our little princess gracefully sleeps, not aware that the Crow Fairy is also coming nearby. It's too late, my dear. You can't hide when there's no moonlight, especially with those wings that shimmer bright. No one can escape from the crow's eyes. There's no place to run, no way to hide. But in a mother's heart, there's always hope. It's safe, all right. A love so deep and strong that not even the darkest evils can set them apart. And when things in the real world are not going right, remember, there's always a fantasy one that can take you places that you never dreamed of. A magical place where everything is possible for those who believe.
I keep dreaming, Bella. Never more has been here.